In today's video, we're going to try to make a lid for our vacuum chamber that lets us use our arc welder in a vacuum. What will happen to the sparks? What will happen if we melt something in the vacuum?
What's up, guys? Josh here. If you didn't already know, we've got brand new merch for sale. We've got two different long sleeve shirts, a new short sleeve shirt, and for the first time ever, I think, a phone case. If you want to check out this awesome stuff, click the link in the description below. And while you're at it, comment below and tell me what your favorite is and what you'd like to see in the future, and maybe we could make that happen.
Guys, we've done some cool experiments using a vacuum chamber, and we have also done some pretty cool experiments using our arc furnace. That runs a ton of electricity through these carbon rods and lets us melt metal. Well, today we want to see if we can combine those by making a lid that will allow us to use our carbon rods down inside the vacuum chamber, and then we'll see what happens if we try and melt something in the vacuum chamber, assuming we can get it to work. What's gonna be the difference when there's no air around our carbon rods? What's gonna be the difference between the arc? How are things going to react or melt differently when they're in a low pressure environment? That's what we hope to find out. The idea is pretty simple. We'll make a new acrylic lid, but we'll add two holes that allow our carbon rods to go inside. We'll seal those up with some proto putty and see what happens if we make an arc inside our vacuum chamber. To get started, we've got our vacuum chamber and we've got this same thick piece of acrylic that our original vacuum chamber lid was cut from. We're gonna cut another one about the same size, drill it the same way we did for this valve, and then we're gonna add a couple more holes that will let us put our carbon rods down through the lid into the vacuum chamber. We'll try and create some proto putty seals that fill those holes, but hold onto the carbon rods so we keep the vacuum as we use the arc furnace down inside. Hopefully the proto putty will be flexible enough that we're also able to move our rods where we want them and have a little bit of control over what's happening. We've got our hole cut and tapped, so we should be able to just thread right into it. We're not going to permanently attach this yet. We're still going to add some thread tape and wait until we've drilled the rest of our holes. That is on there. We should now be able to get our carbon rods down inside there. We're gonna use proto putty to sort of plug up the two holes where the rods are going down in. But proto putty is a flexible rubber, so I should still have the ability to move them a little bit. Hopefully, I'll be able to keep the vacuum seal while that happens. Thank you. All right, we've got proto putty all the way around our carbon rods. Let's let that cure. All right, at this point, we should have everything set up. We're gonna give it a quick test without pulling a vacuum first, just to make sure that these are arcing down inside our jar. Let's give this a shot. I'm gonna say that works. We got our arc down inside the jar. Let's try pulling out all the air and see what happens. Good. We are getting a seal. What the fog? That'll get pulled out in a sec. Okay, now I'm just gonna try turning it on from a distance. Oh! I see smoke. I think that already began burning the proto putty. But you know what was interesting? Is the arc didn't really do much. Like, I thought in theory the arc should be able to extend a lot larger in this situation, but it didn't hold at all. Let that run for a minute to pull more intense vacuum, if it will. Oh, and that's a lot of smoking. The arc in a vacuum didn't really do too much, so I decided I wanted to try something else. I've poured some liquid nitrogen into this soda bottle, and I've got a balloon over the nozzle. So as the nitrogen expands, it's just filling this balloon. So what I should have is a balloon full of pretty much pure nitrogen. And I'm gonna see what happens if I take this balloon, stretch it over the air intake, and then let it back in. That should fill our vacuum chamber with pure nitrogen. I'm not gonna let it go all the way to empty because I do still want there to be suction holding the lid on. All right, almost pure nitrogen atmosphere. There's our smoke point. Arc furnace in a vacuum chamber. It may need some tweaking before we can really do too much with it. The proto putty does a really good job of giving us a little bit of flexibility so we have control while maintaining a vacuum inside. But it does tend to burn pretty quickly, so we may look into whether there are any higher temperature rubber gaskets we can sort of form onto there. It's possible that with something higher temp, we might be able to have longer times where it runs and maybe even melt something down inside. At this point, anything that would melt would have to run so long that it would start burning the proto putty. If proto putty does light on fire if it gets hot enough, I don't want to just burn the proto putty and then catch the acrylic on fire and then the whole studio would burn up. No one wants that. It's also possible that we would have a different result if we had a more perfect vacuum. This vacuum chamber does not pull a perfect vacuum, and whatever is left inside may be able to interfere with how our arc is forming. What do you think? Are there other ideas you think we should try with our arc furnace? Are there other tools you think we should try and set up so that they can be manipulated while inside a vacuum? I think that drilling holes into the top and making a rubber or proto putty seal does work fairly well. It was still holding a vacuum and I was able to move these around, so I might be able to get some other tools or something down inside to be able to move stuff while under low pressure. What would you like to see us do? Guys, the fun doesn't end here. We've got more for you to see. The box at the top will take you directly to our last video. You should go check that out. The other box will show you what YouTube thinks you should be watching next. And if you hit this bomb in the middle, you will be subscribed to our channel. That way you never miss out on a video. Don't forget to ring that bell and we will see you in the next one. Talk to you then.